this first part of chapter 2, dealing with horizontal alignments, horizontal geometry and information, we're going to take a look at the create civil rule feature. What that allows us to do is turn normal microstation geometry into a horizontal element that ORD understands and can work with. So you can create things with regular microstation lines, arcs, even use the smart line tool, and ORD has the ability to turn those into civil elements. Okay, so what we have here are three different types of elements. We have a regular line, which was created with the regular microstation line tool. We have an arc, which is a regular microstation arc. And we have a complex chain, which is the microstation version of that. Okay, as you click on each one of these, you'll notice no information is given on it, on any one of these. And civil geometry always tells us, if it's true civil geometry, a length and a slope, or a start and an end and a length of this, and length and maybe radiuses and so forth of the different elements that create or make up the civil geometry, how they've created. So there's a tool that allows us to convert these elements, and it depends on how you want to convert them. If you want to have a feature definition with each one of those, you could open up the feature definition dialog, which is also underneath our standards here. Feature definition toggle bar or toolbar. That's what this item here is. And I've got it just kind of pulled out and docked. But if we come in and turn this into a element, say a geometry element, whenever you have that turned on, which is the first option to the left there, when you create a civil element, it will take on that particular feature definition. If you don't have any feature definition assigned in there, it'll still just leave it at however it was created in the microstation element, and it won't add an actual feature definition to the item. Okay, so currently I've got geometry scratch turned on, and I've got that first item there turned on, which means it'll use it. So I'm going to go to the design elements pull down. So right now we're in open roads modeling. We're under the geometry tab here, and in this section called general tools, we're going to go to design elements. In design elements, we have the create civil rule feature. So this tool is pretty simple. It does have a little dialog that comes with it. Since we have turned that on in the feature toolbar, it says use active feature, and it gives it a name. You can change that name to whatever you want to. We'll just leave it at geometry scratch for right now. Move out onto the screen, it says locate elements and then reset to complete. So you can do all three of these at once. I'm just going to do this first one and show you how it looks. So we'll left click on that microstation line. Reset to complete is a right mouse click, and it will turn it into the feature definition that we want. Also, if we do element selection and select it, or if you hit F4 and select it, now it's got the information of how it was created. It is now a civil element. Okay. Same thing can happen with an arc here. If you want to change your feature definition to something else, let's say that we'll change it to a building line. Okay, we can come back up into design elements. Create civil rule feature. It's going to name it according to what we've selected. We'll pick on the arc that's out here, reset or right click to complete, and you can see that it changes it to the building feature definition, but it also gives it the radius elements, the length of the curve, and the tangent directions. Turns it into a civil element. So this one here, it has nothing on it. We're going to go ahead and make that something. Let's change that to one of our alignments. Okay, so we've got alignments up here. Let's do a MoDOT baseline proposed. And then we're going to go up to design elements again, create civil rule feature. says baseline proposed. That's the name that it's given it, so that'll be fine. You can see it does have spaces. We don't have a database or anything to go out to anymore, so spaces are fine. And all you have to do is select the element and then right click to complete that, and that will change it into our mo.baseline proposed. And if you select on it, it'll give all the information of how that was created. And you can modify these things. If you click on any of the orange items, you can modify them just like you could if they were created with the civil tools. Okay, if they're gray like this, that just means that you need you do not have the ability to edit those. Okay, so there is no editing of those on the heads up display. They're locked into place. So that is how you go about creating a civil ruled feature from a regular MicroStation element.